Good morning, everyone, and welcome as you join us wherever you are today for our service of morning prayer on this third Sunday of Easter. From the prayer book, and you're very welcome to join us if you have one at home, to open at page 101 as we say the greeting together. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Beloved in Christ, we come together to offer to Almighty God our worship and praise and thanksgiving, to confess our sins and to receive God's forgiveness, to hear his holy word proclaimed, to bring before him our needs and the needs of the world, and to pray that in the power of his Spirit we may serve him and know the greatness of his love. So let us confess our sins to God our Father. Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault, by what we have done and by what we have failed to do. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth will proclaim your praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
We're now going to sing Jesus Loves Me. Our psalm this morning is Psalm 116. Again, if you'd like to follow it in the prayer book, you can find it on page 729. And we're saying verses 10 to 17. How shall I repay the Lord for all the benefits he has given to me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his faithful servants. O Lord, I am your servant, the child of your handmaid. You have freed me from my bonds. I will offer to you a sacrifice of thanksgiving and call upon the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. In the courts of the house of the Lord, in the midst of you, O Jerusalem. Alleluia. And now Christine will bring us our Bible reading.
The reading can be found in Isaiah chapter 43, verses 1 to 12. But thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flames shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Saviour. I give Egypt as your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in exchange for you. Because you are precious in my sight and honoured, and I love you. I give people in return for you, nations in exchange for your life. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east, and from the west I will gather you. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not withhold. Bring my sons from far away, and my daughters from the end of the earth. Everyone who is called by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. Bring forth the people who are blind, yet have eyes, who are deaf, yet have ears. Let all the nations gather together, and let the peoples assemble. Who among them declared this, and foretold to us the former things? Let them bring their witnesses to justify them, and let them hear and say, it is true. You are my witnesses, says the Lord, and my servant whom I have chosen, so that you may know and believe me, and understand that I am he. Before me no God was formed, nor shall there be any after me. I am the Lord, and besides me there is no Saviour. I declared and saved and proclaimed, when there was no strange God among you, and you are my witnesses, says the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word, and we pray now as we look at the scriptures that you will unveil them to us. We thank you for your presence with us. Father, we pray that indeed you enliven our minds, open our hearts to receive you afresh by your Holy Spirit today, that it may be your words we hear and only your words, and respond to you in the power of the Holy Spirit. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Have you ever wondered how many times you may say the pronoun I during any day of your life or my life? We say, I think this, or I thought that, I said this, or I might say that, or I might do this, or I might do that. The word I is a small, small word, one letter, I. How many times do we say it in any given day? It speaks of ownership. I think, I do, I say, all those things, etc. It speaks of ownership. When we say I, we own it, what we say, do, or think. This little letter I is mentioned 19 times in our text today that Christine brought to us from Isaiah 43, verses 1 to 12. 19 times in the NIV version of the Bible. In here, it is God speaking. He says, I. I will do, or I have done, or also parts of his nature as well are mentioned in this scripture. God speaks of who he is in his own nature, also what he has done and what he will do. In other words, a promise yet to come. So let's firstly look at his nature, as Isaiah 43 tells us. There is much in the Bible that God describes of his own nature, who he is in essence. But let's look at this chapter to see what we can glean from it. Verse 3 tells us these words, "For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Saviour." Again in verse 11, a little more about him. I am the Lord. He mentions that little letter I twice, emphasizing that he is the Lord, and besides me, there is no Saviour. And again in verse 12, I declared and saved and proclaimed. These are words of uniqueness, sanctity, and that God is the only channel of salvation for humankind through his Son, Jesus Christ. I am the Lord your God, the Almighty, the Holy One, his sanctity. How holy he is, and our Saviour, the only channel to salvation. But this might seem like a God that is very up there in the sky and very much the almighty, far off looking down God. I declare these things. But let's look at verse 4, something much more personal about his nature unfolds. You are precious in my sight and honored, and I love you. Precious and honored, and I love you. There is the personal side of God speaking into our lives. We are honored and precious in his sight. That's amazing. Those are amazing words. Honored and precious in the almighty creator and yet personal God's sight. God gives love, and he is love. By essence and nature, he is love. That's peppered throughout scriptures. 1 John 4, verse 8 tells us that God is love. In essence, he is love. His nature exudes love. But remember, his love is reciprocal as well. As he gives love to his human beings, his children, his created, he wants to see that love returned back to him. And here lies a challenge to us all. Have we done that with our lives and with our hearts? Or have we yet to do that? Remember, his love is unconditional. It never ends, never is taken from us. But he longs for a relationship with us. That's why his love must be reciprocal, that we give it back with our lives and hearts because of who he is, and now we're going to look at the moment in what he has done for us. Remember, Isaiah 43 is written into the context of exile. The people of Israel are in a foreign place under foreign tyranny. They're away from home, and all that they know, all their culture, perhaps other family members are still back in Israel, and they're under enslavement and pressure in a foreign territory. So these are great words of comfort to the people and a status for us even today that we are God's children. So you might say, so what, Geoffrey? Okay, this is this God who loves me, but I actually don't want to give him love back. Or what has he done for me that I should return this love? There's an advert that has been on the television this last few weeks. I haven't seen this last few days, but it is out there. It shows a little lad. He's in this party in his mother and father's house. And his mum and dad are there with other people, and they're standing around talking, and he's mingling amongst them. And there are little bits of cake on plates set all over the room that he is in. Each adult is getting a slice of cake. And he's trying to lift one for himself, or so we think at the start of the advert. And you see people catching him out and lifting the cake away from him as he tries to take one of the plates. And he comes to his mum, and she's not looking, her back is turned to the plate, and he lifts her slice. And then you see him going upstairs, And he goes into his sister's room. She is playing on a computer. And as siblings do, you hear the words, "Get out of my room. This is my place. What are you doing in here?" And he simply leaves the little plate with cake by her dresser for her. And then you see the smile coming over his sister's face. Almost a smile of forgiveness. "And you are very kind indeed, my brother." It's a little like the picture of God. Sometimes we dip in and out of our relationship with God. We call to Him at certain times in our lives. And then we leave Him for other vast amounts of our life. We might shout out a prayer now and then. Maybe times of crisis or whatever we find ourselves in. And it's only then that we call out to God. When actually He loves us through it all. And the lengths He has gone to, like the little boy to get the slice of cake, to show that love to us. Sometimes it has to be a real smack in the face before we reciprocate with that love back to God. So what has He done for us? Well, let's look what Isaiah 43 teaches us and what God has done for us. Look at verse 1. "Now says the Lord, He who created you, O Jacob, He who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine." Through Jesus, we have redemption. Whether we like it or not, or accept it or not, we live in a sinful world. We are fallen, sinful people. And there has to be a way out of that. We are caught in a web until we can get out of that. And only through God's Son, Jesus, can we get away from that. "I have redeemed you." And we know in the New Testament that Jesus came, God incarnate on earth, to die on the cross for you and for me, that we could have redemption, cleansing from this sin that entangles us, set free. That's what redemption is. And restored in God's eyes. That's the greatest gift He has given to you and to me through Jesus His Son. And God calls us by His love. "I have called you by name. You are mine." And it's through His Holy Spirit that redemption is made complete. We must listen to the still small voice of God speaking to us. "I have called you. Come to me. Receive my love. Reciprocate that love. And I will indeed redeem you from all your sin and trouble that holds us back from a relationship with God the Father." The cross is reciprocal itself. Jesus gives the ultimate in love to humankind for the forgiveness of sins, to be set free, to know His salvation and eternal life. But we must receive it. It's done and dusted, the one for all sacrifice, but we must receive it into our lives to know that salvation. Look at verse 11 again. I am the Lord. Besides me, there is no other Savior. And what He has done for us, He has declared, "I have spoken, I have saved and proclaimed." Through Jesus Christ, we can know that relationship in the Father. And verse 1 again, "He who created you, O Jacob, He who formed you, O Israel." And there is a difference between creation and formation. Jacob, the Old Testament father, you remember the story, you may do, where he had a wrestle with an angel and his hip was put out of place in that wrestling. He was known as Jacob up to that point, but God gave him a new name after that wrestling match and called him Israel, from hence the nation was called as well. Jacob was the old man with a new relationship in God. He now had a new name. He was no longer just a creation. He was formed in God. He had a new formation in God. You see, we are all created, but are we formed in God in a new life, a new person? Jacob became Israel from his creation to a new formation in God. And finally, what God will do in Isaiah 43. We have his nature, we have what he has done for us, and now what he will do in promise. He doesn't promise an easy life. Nowhere in the Bible do we have a picnic in life. Look at these words in verse 2 of Isaiah 43. When you pass through the waters and through the rivers, when you walk through fire and the flame, that's really part of the troubles that we can have in our lives. But look at the second part of each of those words, those lines. I will be with you, says God. They shall not overwhelm you. You shall not be burned, and the flame will not consume you. He is with us. I will be with you, a promise. Remember again, we are precious in his sight. Verse 4, honored, and I love you. I give people in return for you, nations in exchange for your life. That's the extent of what God will do for us. And for everyone, the gospel message is for the whole world. Because we see that in verses 5 and 6. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east and from the west. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not withhold. Bring my sons from far away and my daughters from the end of the earth. It's the whole world. This love is for the whole world. And finally, I hope and pray that we do receive God's love afresh today, or even for the first time, in coming to the foot of the cross and acknowledging him as our Saviour, the only Saviour, because God is love. He has given us this love, and he wants us to receive it and give it back to him in love. But we must do it. It is there for the taking, but we must receive it for ourselves in spirit and in truth. And finally, we become his witnesses. That is another challenge in this part of Scripture, but throughout Scripture, when we receive God as our Saviour, we take that message. Don't keep it to ourselves, but give it to others. Be my witnesses, says the Lord. Verse 12, I declared, I saved, I proclaimed, when there was no strange God among you, and you are my witnesses, says the Lord. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you indeed that you're a God of love, but also judgment as well. A God, Lord, who one day indeed, when we pass from this world, will have to answer for all our doings. Father, we pray indeed that we know your love today, which is unconditional to all of us, that we know it through the cross, that you gave your all there. And Father, all you ask is that we receive it and return it with our lives to you. That we know the forgiveness of sins through the cross. That anything can be forgiven, whatever we have done, said, or thought. And that we get a new life and restored in the Father's eyes through that. And live a life of witness for you. Lord, help us to know your nature today. That it is a personal nature, that we can have a personal relationship to you, through you and in you. Because you love us. Father, help us indeed to always remember that you are with us and go through us through everything that's difficult in life, because we can stand on your promises and that they are through. And we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. You're very welcome to join me now in the words of the Apostles' Creed on page 112 in the prayer book. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
O Lord, guide and defend our rulers,
and grant our government wisdom.
Let your ministers be clothed with righteousness,
and let your servants shout for joy.
O Lord, save your people,
and bless those whom you have chosen.
Give peace in our time, O Lord,
and let your glory be over all the earth.
O God, make clean our hearts within us,
and renew us by your Holy Spirit.
The Collect for the third Sunday of Easter. Almighty Father, who in your great mercy gladdened the disciples with the sight of the risen Lord, give us such knowledge of his presence with us that we may be strengthened and sustained by his risen life, and serve you continually in righteousness and truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And you can join me in the Collects on page 114 for morning prayer, and we'll say Collects 1 and 2 on that page. O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you is eternal life, and to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in your protection, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, almighty and ever-living God, we give you thanks for bringing us safely to this day. Keep us from falling into sin or running into danger, and in all things guide us to know and do your will, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now Christine is going to lead us in our intercessions.
Heavenly Father, we pray for our world, where there is war, bring peace, in sickness, bring healing, for the hungry, provide nutrition on prosperous land. For those living in fear, bring peace of mind, and those who are lonely or grieving, surround them in the comfort of your love. Whatever we face, wherever we are in the world, help us to remember that you are faithful to your promises, and resting in that, in turn, help us to be faithful to you. Almighty Father, whose will it is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of all, govern the hearts and minds of those in authority, and bring the families of the nations divided and torn apart by the ravages of sin to be subject to his just and gentle rule. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, we thank you for our communities. You taught us to love our neighbour and to care for those in need, as if we were caring for you. All around us we are seeing amazing examples of our communities pulling together to love, care for and help one another. Help us to continue this into the future. In this time of anxiety, give us strength to comfort the fearful, tend to the sick, and to assure the isolated of our love, and your love for your name's sake. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, for those who are sick and grieving, may your healing hand rest upon them. May your life-giving power flow into every cell of their bodies and into the depth of their souls, cleaning, purifying, restoring them to wholeness and strength for service in your kingdom. And Lord, for those who have to continue to work at the minute to provide services for all of us to survive, healthcare, retail, cleaners, and many, many more. We thank you for them. Protect them as they all make great sacrifices for us. Father, thank you for our church family. I pray that you watch over them and keep them safe. May we always be accountable to one another and never demean one another, but always encourage each other in times of blessings and of trials. Amen. May you be wrapped up in God's love, found deep in his everlasting arms, carried, kept safe, and cherished, and may he surround you in his peace. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you for joining with us this day for our service. Do join us again on Wednesday morning at 11 a.m. as we meet around the scriptures again. Let's pray together. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us this day and forevermore. Amen. May God indeed be with you until we meet again, keep you safe and in his blessing.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all and all, here